Hi, my name is Melissa van Dijk. Now, can you use the ordinary AHA BHA peeling solution with glycolic, lactic or salicylic acid? Now, the short answer is no, since the peeling solution already contains those exfoliating acids, but it may not be that obvious because it's not stated that way. So the AHA refers to alpha hydroxy acids, and under that category you have different exfoliating acids. One of the main ones would be glycolic acid, followed by lactic acid, tartaric acid, and then lastly citric acid. Those would be the AHAs that the peeling solution contains. And then on the other hand, you have BHA, which refers to beta hydroxy acid, and this is salicylic acid. So the peeling solution already contains those exfoliating acids, therefore it's best to not use any other exfoliating acid products in that same routine when using the peeling solution. And the peeling solution should only be used once to twice per week, or even less often when using already other exfoliating acids in that same week, so that you can avoid irritation, because this is likely to occur when exfoliating the skin too much. And so to visualize this even further, I have prepared for you an entire PowerPoint going over at first what not to use in the same routine, so that you have this in mind. And then I want to share with you an example frequency guide, so that you then know how you can balance it throughout the entire week. So we are starting off with the conflicts, as you can see right here, which I have prepared for you in a PowerPoint, which as always you can download in the description box down below. Now, when it comes to leave-on exfoliating acid products, this refers to exfoliating acid products like toners, liquids, like essence, or even sometimes called serums, that contain exfoliating acids that you're going to apply to the skin and then leave on the skin, so there's no need to wash it off. So if you have one of them at home, or maybe a similar product that you can see right here, please do not use it in the same routine when using the peeling solution. This can potentially lead to not only dryness, but stinging, burning, and even in the worst case a damaged skin barrier. So therefore avoid this, use them on different days. Then the same can apply when it comes to regular exfoliating acid cleansers, where the pH is around skin's pH, as you can see right here. And it's not so much about stinging or burning. I mean, this can occur depending on how your skin is going to tolerate it, but much often it refers to experiencing dryness, and then when using the peeling solution afterwards, this then may create more sensitivity than necessary. So therefore, again, please do not use them in the same routine. And then next up, we are working with highly acidic cleansers, which aren't that common, but there are some of them cleansers on the market where the pH is known and it's pretty low, and therefore it can be quite intense if you would use them in the same routine. And therefore, again, do not do this, use them on different days. So I just want to keep the focus towards exfoliating acid products, so that you have an idea of what we are talking about. This can be rinse-off products, this can be leave-on products. So again, do not use them in the same routine. And I now want to head into an example frequency guide, so that you have something in mind. So we are starting off with the peeling solution, which you usually would use in the evening. And don't forget, it is a rinse off mask. So after you have washed your face with a regular cleanser that's suitable for your skin type, pat your skin dry, wait 5 to 10 minutes in between for your skin to fully dry, and then head into the application of the peeling solution, since it needs to be applied to dry skin. Apply it evenly all over, leave it on the skin for 10 minutes, rinse off with only water, and then again pat the skin dry, and then my recommendation would be following with hydration afterwards. So you can see the example routine set up right here, which you can follow. This is something that I can recommend. Of course, if you have different hydrating products, you could then use them afterwards as well. And then below that, you have the overall general guide of how you should use it. But now I want to keep the main focus towards the days. So you want to use your peeling solution in the same week as if you would use your other exfoliating acid cleansers or leave-on products. So let's assume that you're going to use the peeling solution every Sunday. So once per week, or every second Sunday, depending on how much exfoliation your skin needs. But you should get the idea. So let's just point a day to Sunday. This is going to be your peeling solution day. Well, now throughout the rest of the week, you can work with the other exfoliating acids, but I have categorized them because it depends on how intense they are and what products you have chosen. So let's move on to exfoliating acid cleansers, the regular ones at first. which you can see right here. And I've created a morning as well as evening skincare routine into one slide, so you would only use the sunscreen during daytime. In the evening, there's no sunscreen needed. And you may want to do a double cleanse in the evening to properly remove your sunscreen and or makeup. Now you will find everything below again. But the main point right here is the frequency that I've mentioned above. So you can start by using it every other day and then gradually increase the frequency if needed and as tolerated, because not everyone has the same tolerance and not everyone needs the same like amount of exfoliation. And then you can use such a regular exfoliating acid cleanser in the morning and or evening when not using the peeling solution. And then depending on the frequency that you are currently trying or trying to adjust to, if sensitivity occurs, then reduce the frequency and give the skin more time to adjust. So this is very individual with such cleansers. For some people, they can use it pretty much every day when not using the peeling solution. For others, you may just want to give your skin a break in between. So therefore, you have the like guidance right here. Then when it comes to highly acidic cleansers, which again, I've mentioned already earlier, the frequency can change quite a bit because they tend to be a bit more potent, a bit more like kind of like aggressive on the skin because they have a low pH, because they have maybe a bit more of a higher like percentage of glycolic, lactic or salicylic acid in it. So you have two examples right here. And then the frequency would be by starting off using it on Tuesday, Wednesday and or Friday. So generally speaking, 2 to 3 times per week in the morning or evening. I wouldn't overdo it with such exfoliating acid cleansers because they can be quite intense. But of course, the frequency can be adjusted, and even over time, you may be able to use it more often. That's completely fine. You can slowly increase it, but take your time. And again, if sensitivity occurs, give your skin a break and use it less often. Then when it comes to leave-on exfoliating acid products, I have categorized them in an evening skincare routine, keeping the focus only on glycolic acid products, because glycolic acid tends to be a bit more potent compared to other AHAs like lactic acid or mandelic acid. Therefore, I put them into a separate category. So then I recommend, again, working with it a Tuesday, Wednesday, and or Friday. And this is only going to be your evening skincare routine. So with exfoliating acid cleansers, you could use them in the morning and or evening, whereas with your leave-on exfoliating acid products, just use them in the evening. And then this would be the frequency that you can start off with. Again, if your skin has a much better tolerance, you could go ahead and adjust it, maybe use it more often, but give your skin the time. And then this would be the example routine that you then can potentially follow. And you have the overall general guide below. Then when it comes to less, not really potent products, but they tend to not sting as much on the skin or burn on the skin than glycolic acid can potentially do, we are looking into salicylic acid and or lactic acid products. So you have the description right here on the top. And with such exfoliating acid products, you can use it every other day up to daily because they tend to be much gentler. They tend to not cause that stinging or burning as much as it may refer to a glycolic acid product. Therefore, the frequency can change. Therefore, you may be able to use that one more often. And so then again, this would be then the frequency and example routine that you can potentially follow if you just want to keep the focus towards exfoliating acid products. Now, the entire frequency guide just refers to exfoliating acid products. I mean, if you now are thinking of working with a retinol or a strong vitamin C product, the entire frequency is going to change. So I just want to be clear, I'm only keeping the focus towards exfoliating acid products when working with your peeling solution and maybe exfoliating as a cleansers or leave-on products. And so then this would be another example on how you then can adjust it and work with such products throughout the week. Now, what are you going to do when not using your like leave-on exfoliating acid product, your cleanser or mask? Well, then you're going to keep the routine fairly simple. You're just going to wash your face with a regular cleanser. Maybe you want to do a double cleanse in the evening, then follow with hydration afterwards or maybe other treatments that you have. But overall, then this would be the example routine. So you're basically leaving out your exfoliating acid product or exfoliating acid mask on those days. And it's not wrong to give your skin a break in between if you feel that it's needed, because your skin then has the time to rest and recover from it. And then when it comes to an example morning skincare routine, I just want to keep the focus towards what's important to do in the morning, which would be washing your face with your favorite cleanser and then protecting the skin with your sunscreen throughout the day. Especially when working with exfoliating acid products, you want to make sure that you protect the skin with your sunscreen so that you're not getting burnt, because this is something that can easily happen since you're exfoliating skin. Like, you let go of the dead skin cells, the new skin cells are still a bit more sensitive, so you want to protect the skin very carefully with your sunscreen if you have sun exposure. And so then this would be the entire example guide when it comes to balancing it out with your peeling solution as well as exfoliating acid cleansers or leave-on products. Below the example routines, below the example frequency guide, you will find the skincare product description box. So if you are looking into a specific product that I have just mentioned, well, you will find everything down below with a little explanation next to it, since those are all products that I can recommend that I like to use myself. But you have the entire list right here. And then below that, you have an overall general skincare guide when working with skincare products, what's important to remember. And the same would apply to sunscreen information, why it is important and when it is needed. And this is basically everything that you will find in the entire PowerPoint. So I can highly recommend it if you want to go over it again in your own time, you want to adjust the frequency, you want to follow a routine, use a product, you will be able to download it in the description box down below. And so I do hope that you enjoyed this video, that you find it helpful. If you did so, please don't forget to give the thumbs up as well as share it. And if you want to support my channel, as I'm an independent YouTuber, and you want to leave a tip, I would be grateful for it. And you can do this by clicking on the super thanks button below this video, or check out the description box, there you will find a PayPal link. Now, thank you so much for watching. If you now want to head into the application where I'm going to do the demonstration as well, I'm going to leave such videos at the end of this video so that you can keep on watching. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you soon in the next one. Happy skincaring. Bye.